Yes, good morning to everybody. Welcome to the class. There is All India Bar Examination. That is the 16th cohort, 2021. Yes, in the today topic that I'm going to deal is administrative law and what I told yesterday. So now I could hear your voice. That means I can proceed well. So this is a good morning, which is salutation which I put it with the yellow color flowers with my name, Professor Dr. Mohammad Sahib Hussain. So let us directly go to the actually the administrative law is concerned. Yeah, then All India Bar Examination, that is XV1, that is the 16th cohort, this is 2021 administrative law, the MCQ means multiple choice questions. Yeah, the first question goes in this manner. The first question, as per dash, the administrative law is the law relating to the administration. It determines the organization, powers and duties of the administrative authorities. Who said? Is a Lord Dorogomor or Gilbert Van Dicey, Ivar Jennings or Frank Goodnow? Who is that person who said such a definition? So the right answer is Ivar Jennings said. And what he said, as per Ivar Jennings, the administrative law is the law relating to the administration. It determines the organization, power and duties of the administrative authorities. Second question, administrative law is a branch of dash. Is it a private law? Is it a public law? Is it a adjunctive law? Is it absolute law? Which one is the right answer?
Public law. Public
law. It is a very good. I appreciate it. It's a public law. Good. Administrative law is not dash law. It is a dash law which evolved over the times. A. Codified and judgmental law. B. Here B is not properly written. B. Yeah. B. A judgmental and codified law. C. Judicial activism. And D. PIL. Which is appropriate?
Sir, PIL.
No, it is a public interest litigation. No. It is not a codified law. Administrative law is not a codified law. It is a judgmental law. Only cases are there. It is not codified law like law of tort, and it's a judgment law, means judicial decisions are there. Yes, the principle dash was abolished and the scope of the administrative law expanded with the various by virtue of the Crown Proceedings Act in 1947, which allowed the initiating the civil proceedings against the Crown as against any private person. Number A, think and do no wrong. B, rex non potest peccare. C, only A correct. D, both A and B correct. Answer is, kin can do wrong, yes, was abolished in the scope of administrative law. And Crown Proceeding Act 1947 is made. And what is the kin can do no wrong is said to be the, in Latin terminology, rex non potest peccare. That means D is the answer. Both A and B correct. That is the answer. The fifth question, dash was the first case wherein the existence of the administrative law in the United Kingdom was declared. So what is the case now, where it is declared? I give the four cases here. That is Cyril Lasrado dead by LRS and V. Juliana Maria Lasrado and another disciplinary authority come regional manager versus Nikunja Bihari Patnaik. And Breen versus Amalgamated Engineering Union and a State of Maharashtra versus Vitthal Rao. The answer is, the case law is here is Breen versus Amalgamated Engineering Union is the right answer for the question. The sixth question, in the United States of America, the existence of an administrative law and the growth of the ignored until it is grew to become the dash of the state. Second branch, third branch, fourth branch, fifth branch. It is the fourth branch of the state. Yes, seventh question. Dash of the ancient India had a centralized administrative system. The Guptas and the Mauryans, the Mauryans and the Guptas, are only A is correct or only B is correct? Answer is
Sir,
the Mauryans and the Guptas of ancient
B.
India
B.
as a centralized. Answer is B. That is the B. Only B is correct. The D I put it over there. The only B is correct. So that is the right answer for that one. That is goes the Mauryans and the Guptas. Yes. The eighth question. After independence, India adopted it became a dash, which henceforth increased the state activities. State welfare, welfare state. Only A is correct. Only B is correct. Yes. Welfare state.
Yes, state welfare.
It is a lissage. That is lissage fair. Lissage. Let it be. That is the French word. French word. Lissage fair. Lissage fair. The pronunciation is different. Let it be. That is the French word. From there, it has become the welfare state. Yes, as the activities and powers of the government and the administrative authorities increased, so did the need for dash and judicial review of the state action. Rule of law and judicial review of the state action, or judicial review of the state action and rule of law, are only A is correct or only B is correct? Answer is, it is both. It is a rule of law and judicial review of the state action means A is correct. That means C, only A is correct. C, A is correct. That is the answer for that one. The tenth question. Henceforth, if rules, regulations and orders passed by the administrative authorities were found to be beyond the authorities' legislative power, then such orders, rules and regulations were to be declared dash one among four is not relevant. Means I said not relevant. Ultra-virus, constitutional, illegal, wide. Answer is unconstitutional actually should be, but I wrote the constitutional here. That means B is not supporting the proposition. So actually it should be unconstitutional, it should be there. Ultra-virus, unconstitutional, illegal, wide. But I wrote B, constitutional. So they do not have the support the among four. So there is not. So 11th question. As the state changed their nature from dash to that of a dash, government activities increased. Does the need to regulate the same, that this branch of law is law developed by laissez-faire and welfare state, welfare state, laissez-faire, a laissez-faire and laissez-faire, welfare state and welfare state? The answer is laissez-faire and welfare state. The pronunciation is laissez, laissez-faire, laissez-faire, laissez-faire. French word, let it be. That is the meaning of it. So the right answer is the A. The right answer is nature from the laissez-faire to that of a welfare state. The 12th question.
Good morning, sir.
Very, very morning.
Morning,
welcome.
Sir.
Welcome, sir. Welcome, sir.
Sir, sir, sorry, late today.
Oh, no, no, no matter, no matter, no matter. No matter. Okay, okay, okay. Administrative law, hence, is subordinate to constitutional law. I repeat, administrative law, hence, is subordinate to the constitutional law. In other words,
yes, sir, exactly.
While constitution is the dash, and administrative law is a specie, which is specie, which is genus. Yes?
Sir, yes, sir. Yeah.
Hmm.
Sir, administrative is the species, sir. Constitution is the genus.
Yeah, yeah. The answer is here C, genus and specie. Actually, it should be removed there, actually. But I wrote.
Gene, sir. Gene is from constitution, sir.
Constitution is a broader spectrum, and the administrator is the specie. That is the answer.
Gene from constitution.
Yes, yes, yes. Constitution deals with the dash of the state and its various organs. Administrative law, on the other hand, deals only with the dash. Administration and structure, or structure and administration, or structure and structure, or D, administration and administration. Which is the appropriate word? Here, answer is Constitution deals with the structure. Constitution deals with the structure of the state and its various organ. Administrative law, on the other hand, deals with the administration. That is the administrative law. So, while constitution touches all the branch of law, yes.
What is the answer, sir?
I don't know. Constitution is a structure, and administration law is the administration. That the B is the answer. Constitution is the structure, and administrative law is only the administration. So, while constitution touches all the branches of law and deals with the general principles relating to organization and power of the various organs of the state, administrative law deals only with the powers and function of the administrative authorities. So, one is structure, another is administrative authorities. So, 14th question. Simply speaking, the administrative authorities would first follow the dash, then work as per the dash. So, now, A, constitution and administrative law. B, administrative law and constitution. C, only A is correct. D, only B is correct.
Sir, yes, sir. Constitution and administrative.
Constitution and administrative law. That is the right answer.
Right.
First to follow the constitution and then work as per the administrative law. Because constitution is the genus and administrative law is the species. Okay, 15th question. There are three measures of the controlling the abuse of powers through delegated legislation as adapted in India. But one is not among them. Parliamentary control, judicial review, administrative adjudication tribunals, or Lokayukta and Lokapal Act 2013. Which one is the not? Goes with the. It is Lokayukta and Lokpal. Actually, it should be Lokpal and Lokayukta. The sequence is first comes Lokpal and Lokayukta's Act 2013. But intentionally, what I did it, no? I kept it Lokayukta and Lokpal Act 2013 in the D. So, which is not means D attracts here. But the right answer is Lokpal and Lokayukta Act, which attracts the above question. 16th question.
Lokpal from center, sir. Lokayukta state.
Do you have the both in Telangana?
Telangana, we have only Lokayukta, Lokpal from center, sir.
Lokayukta, where it is in there?
Lokayukta only it controls state level. Lokpal at parliament.
Okay. But do they really do any work, or it is like a without teeth? These bodies are without teeth.
Like
what I observed, human rights, he doesn't have the vicious teeth.
Yeah.
I was thinking that immediately that can be done. Then later I found to know. Doorapu kondalu nunupu. Okay. 16th question. Administrative law requires that the administrative adjudicatory authority adjudicates the matter applying the principles of natural justice, which are namely, and one among them is not. Connect to the proposition. A. Rule against the bias. B. Adi alteram partem. C. Speaking order or reasoned decision. And D. Judicial review of the administrative action. Actually, it is not a judicial review of the administrative action. It is judicial control of the administrative action. So, I kept it judicial review instead of judicial control of the administrative action. That means D is not connected with the above proposition. The right answer is judicial control of the administrative action is the right point here. So, next 17th question. The judiciary keeps a check on the other organs of the state through judicial review. The grounds on which this power is exercised on the administrative authority and one among the four is not connected to statement. So, use of discretion, failure to exercise discretion, illegality, irrationality, procedural impropriety. answer is, feedback is abuse of discretion. See, I use the use of discretion, I say. Actually, here it is abuse of discretion. So instead of writing the abuse of discretion, I use only the use of discretion. That means among the four, A is not connected with the proposition which is stated in the 17th question. The right answer is abuse discretion, in the full. Failure to exercise discretion, number two. Illegality, irrationality, procedural improperty. These are all that which is support the 17Q. Ombudsman is a check on the dash by the legislature.
It is correct, sir. Check.
Yes.
What was after four?
I said the first one. I say, I write use of discretion, I wrote, but actually it should be abuse of discretion. So this is not connected. What should be written? Abuse of discretion. But what I wrote? Use of discretion. Agreed? Yes. Now say, ombudsman is a check on the dash by the legislature. Procedural bodies, practical bodies, administrative bodies, constitutional bodies. Yes.
Sir, administrative
body. It is administrative body. Because it is administrative law. Right. The aim of the administrative law is not to take away the discretionary power of the executive, but to bring them in consonance with the dash. This is where welfare state, rule of law, free state. Which one is the appropriate? Laissez-faire, welfare state. See, rule of law. The free state answer is rule of law. The 20th question is human rights, recognition of the transgender person as a third gender. A case of the parent. Recognition of the third gender, hijra, transgender, binary gender, mitta, advert lodu. Justice case of Puttaswamy versus Union of India. National Legal Service Authority versus Union of India. Navtej Singh Johar versus Union of India. Vishaka versus State of Rajasthan. Answer is National Legal Service Authority versus Union of India. That is the case law where transgender also be taken as a consideration. He, she, and binary gender or transgender. Yeah, 21 question. In dash, the Supreme Court held that under the Banking Companies Act 1949, the Reserve Bank was the sole judge to decide whether a banking company's affair were being conducted in a manner that was detrimental to the interest and the depositors, and the court had no option but to pass a warning order as the Reserve Bank prayed. And this is happening in one of the case law. Here the four options I have given you. Ram Javaya, Javed Rasul Bhatt, Joseph Purvilla, Velu Kunnal. Then Ranjit Thakur, the answer is Joseph Kurvilla, Velu Kunnal versus RBI, Reserve Bank of India. In this case, that is decided. 22 question. That is, according to Dash, I quote, administrative law is the law concerning the power and procedures of administrative agencies, including especially the law governing judicial review of the administrative action, I unquote. Who said, according to J&J, according to Wade, according to Casey Davis, or according to Garner? Answer is, lucky chance. Gurtu pettukovali ida bandi gurtu. Idu evaru cheppinadi ante, because there is no hard and fast rule. Because you have to make it some mnemonics, then you have to remember it. This is said by the Casey Davis. Casey Davis gave the such a definition. Okay. Dicey in that 19th century defined it as and one among four is not connected to the Dicey definition. In the Narit Lokati Matran Dicey definition correct kadu at the end. Firstly, the portion of the nation legal system. Secondly, defines the right and liabilities. Thirdly, he specifies the procedure for enforcing. And fourthly, he specifies the practical for enforcing those rights. And if you happen to see, thirdly, there I made a mistake. I committed an a different right. Thirdly, he spells the procedure for enforcing those rights. And here I say, enforcing those rights and liabilities. No. Those rights and liabilities. Thirdly, he specifies the procedure for enforcing those rights and liabilities. So now, this is the, it is not there, which is not connected with this one. The thirdly, he specifies the procedure for enforcing those rights and liabilities. So that is the feedback for that one. And actually, if you see the fourth one, if you happen to see the fourth one, fourthly, he specifies that practical for enforcing those rights. So here, if you say those rights and liabilities, fourthly, he specifies the practical, I wrote, but actually there should be a procedure. The procedure for the enforcing those rights, that is the actual word. Means D is the wrong, which is not connected with the proposition. Because I wrote the practical, actually it should be the procedure. The procedure should be there, and which I give in the feedback. That is, he specified the procedural for enforcing these rights and liabilities. And 24th question, as Dash says, before the days of the automobile, there was no need for the policeman to direct traffic because there was no traffic. Who said? Poland, Roland, Raleigh, Hercules.
Poland, sir.
Yeah. It is Roland, he said. As Roland says, before the day of the automobile, there was no need for the policeman to direct traffic because there was no traffic. If the Roland says, and Poland is the place name, a rally. What is rally? Yes? Anyone? Rally cycled, sir. Rally. Hero.
Rally cycle.
Yes.
Correct.
Oh, yes,
sir.
Cycles. Rally cycle unde oka zamanala. Rally chesi oka Philips ready vachi full. Okay. The administrative authorities have dash powers. Mandatory power, discretionary power, obligatory power, absolute power. Which one is the appropriate?
Mandatory, sir. Mandatory.
Yes,
sir.
It is the B, discretionary power. It is the discretionary powers is the right answer. In this context, the basic principle of administrative law are, what is the basic principle of administrative law? A, the judicial review of administrative action, the prevention of the misuse, abuse of power, the provision of the suitable remedies, all of the above. Here the answer is all of the above, because the judicial review of the administrative action is there in the administrative law, and the prevention of the misuse and abuse of the power is there, and the provision for the suitable remedies also available under the administrative law. 27th question, IP Massey identifies the basic bricks of the administrative law foundation as A, checking the use of administrative power, B, to ensure that citizens are not able to determine, C, to make the those who could not exercise public power, D, none of the above. Answer is none of the above, because everything that I made the negative. So checking the abuse of the power, administrative power. So here they checking the use of administrative power, I said. See, I said use, but actually it is abuse. Means that is wrong. Next, to ensure that citizens are able to determine, but to ensure the citizens are not. Here, not is, I made it, but actually it is to ensure that the citizens are able to. So that is the negative answer. To make those who exercise public power, here you say, to make those who could not exercise public power, this is also negative answer. That means total negative answers. So none of the above. The right answer is, read. Anyone? Read. Right answer is A. In the feedback for the 27th question.
Taking the abuse of administrative power to ensure that citizens are able to determine their duty impartially by official in order to protect them from unauthorized violation of their rights and interests. See, to make those who exercise public power accountable to the people.
Yes. So actually, those are the 3 points. Yes, 28th question. Dash, the Supreme Court held that the purpose of the rule of natural justice to secure justice or put it in a negative way to prevent the miscarriage of justice. This rule can only work areas that are not covered by any validity made by law. In other words, they are not supplanting land law but supplementing it. I repeat, they are not supplanting land law but supplementing it. Who said in case law? S. G. Jaisinghani versus Union of India, or Manake Gandhi versus Union of India, A. K. Kariyapak versus Union of India, A. D. Jabalpur versus Shivakant Shukla. So which case law it is dealt in Supreme Court? A.K. Kariyapak versus Union of India, it is decided. Yes, I appreciate. 29th question. Judicial review is the dash and essence of the rule of law. It is a dash of rule of law. Custodian and touchstone are touchstone and custodian. Only A is correct or only B is correct. So judicial review is the touchstone and essence of the rule of law. It is a custodian of the rule of law. So answer is B. Only B is correct.
Only B.
Yes, that is the answer. The B is the correct. That is the B means touchstone. Next, custodian of law. Yes, what is touchstone? Anyone?
Touchstone.
Bro, house lo dagger poyina ankonde vadu touchstone la konja geekutadu chustadu bangaram correct unnada ledha ani. Adi touchstone. 30th question. Dash, in this an introduction to American Administrative Law 1985, defines the administrative law as the law applicable to those administrative agency which possess power of delegated legislation and are ad judiciary authority. Warden Phillips chepara, Bernard Savard chepara, according to Warden, according to Austin. Who said?
Austin.
This is given by the Bernard Savard, and he has given the definition in this one. Sometimes no definition, you have to be very careful, because at least one definition may also be asked then, which is famous. So at least remember one definition. Yeah, that is a very important factor. Yes, yes. So in this way, I completed a total 30. Then if you happen to see what are to be covered or what is not covered, and yes, then let us go from the upper one. So constitutional law, we did it. IPC, we did it. Only CRPC, CPC, that later we'll see. And evidence, we did it. Alternate dispute, we did it. Family law, we did it. Public interest litigation, we did it. Administrative law, yes, now we did it. Professional ethics, company law, completed. Environmental law, completed. Cyber law, completed. Labor immigration law, completed. Law of tort, completed. Now, tomorrow what I do, Land Acquisition Act, 2 marks question I will do it. Because if I do the 2 marks question, the Land Acquisition Act, later on the taxation, only 2 are left, that is the CRPs and CPs. And I will make it a last resort where I have to work hard to see that I could put the justification for that regard. Yes, any other thing that you would like to ask, you can ask me now. Still, you have some minutes in your hand. Yes. If anything that you would like to ask, you can ask me. Yes.
Sir, good morning, sir.
Very good morning. Chepandi, madam.
Sir, land, sir, cases AIBE lo rase appudu akkada takku time lo ee cases ela telustundi sir, edo okati petteyatvena
ippudu point endante negative marks levu kabatti meeru anni case lo okati meeku adrushyam baagundi chadindi achindi ankonde is well and good, raled ankonde just logic use cheyandi vesesayandi ante. ఎందుకంటే కేసులు గుర్తుపెట్టుకోవడం అంటే కొంచెం కష్టమే, అయితే కొన్ని ల్యాండ్ మార్క్ కేసులు మాత్రం గుర్తుపెట్టుకోవాలి. ఇప్పుడు అడ్మినిస్ట్రేట్ లా ఏదన్నా ల్యాండ్ మార్క్ కేసులు ఉన్నదా లేవా, అందులో ఎట్లాంటిది అని గుర్తుపెట్టుకోవాలి. కొన్ని అట్లాంటివి గుర్తుపెట్టుకున్నాయి అనుకోండి, ఎస్ వీ కెన్ మేక్ ఇట్ అవుట్. సపోజ్ వీ కెన్ నాట్ మేక్ ఇట్ అవుట్, ఎస్ యూజ్ ద లాటర్ బికాస్ దర్ ఇస్ నో నెగిటివ్ మార్క్స్ ఫర్ దట్ వన్. సో మీరు లాజిక్ చూసినప్పుడు ఓకే వచ్చేస్తుంది, లేకుంటే రాదు. బికాస్ దర్ ఇస్ నో నెగిటివ్ మార్క్స్, బట్ ఇన్స్టెడ్ ఆఫ్ కీపింగ్ వేకెంట్ బెటర్ యూ ఫిల్ ఇట్. అదృష్టం బాగున్నది అనుకోండి తగిలితాయి, అదృష్టం బాగాలేదు అనుకోండి పోతాయి. పోతే కూడా యు ఆర్ నాట్ ఎ లూజర్, వచ్చింది అనుకోండి యు ఆర్ ద గెయినర్. ఎస్ ఎనీ అదర్ థింగ్?
Yes,
any other question that you would like to ask me?
Tomorrow land acquisition is very important, that also for us.
Yeah. We will see that what is the land acquisition, how we can make it out.
I am agriculture.
Land acquisition.
Basically.
So tomorrow class is land acquisition, then we will see how best we can make it out. So with this, I would like to stop my today's lecture. I will see you tomorrow at the same timings. And that is the land acquisition. Bye.
Thank you, sir.
Yes, welcome, sir. Welcome. Okay, sir. Leave meeting, right? Leave meeting.
See the captain. Cancel. Separate vehicle, sir. Thank you for the greeting.
Yeah, sir. Classroom participants, like leave meeting.
Site.
Yeah.
I'm not seeing it.
Feedback
of WhatsApp. Yes, sir. I see 30 patients out of 20 coming positive.
Okay.
Tomorrow morning also one patient.